It says, when we're in heaven, what are we going to be doing? I have no idea. How will we spend our time? Having a really good time. Let me answer this question in the antithesis. Unfortunately, I do believe that many people have fallen prey to this very poor theology. That one day when we get to heaven, we're all going to sit on the clouds and play a harp. I don't find that anywhere in the Bible. Okay, I don't find it anywhere. What I do find is this. I find, per the previous question, Revelation chapter 21, new heaven, new earth, new Jerusalem, correct? Can we all agree that's a new creation? Okay, go to Isaiah chapter 45 real quick. Isaiah chapter 45 in your Old Testament. I believe we're going to verse 18, if memory serves me correctly. Now, this is not a passage about the new heaven, the new earth. This is actually a passage about Genesis 1, okay? It says, "For thus saith the Lord that created the heavens, God himself that formed the earth and made it. He has established it. He created it not in vain. He formed it to be inhabited. I am the Lord and there is none else." So if his original creation was formed to be inhabited, does it not make sense that the new creation was meant to be inhabited? Okay? So again, when you look at the comparison of the old to the new, again, I do not have a degree in astrophysics. I think we all understand that. But you take any reputable person who looks through a telescope, and they will tell you that our known universe is tens of millions of light years in diameter. That's pretty big, right? Can you imagine, just for the sake of illustration, that here we have an identical, by the way, I think it's going to be bigger and better, but just pretend it's the same. Can you imagine an identical creative order of all of that stuff that, according to what we just read, is meant to be inhabited? So the question is, what are we going to do? We have a really good time, is what we're going to do. All right. Again, are there passages in the Bible where it focuses on us worshiping? Yes. But go to Revelation chapter 22. I promise I won't belabor the question too long. Revelation chapter 22. Now, I am not trying to over personify the quote unquote eternity, but when you get to Revelation 22, you're in eternity, okay? He showed me a pure water, water of life, clear as crystal, coming out of the throne, et cetera, et cetera. It bore its manner of nations, 12 months. There shall be no more curse, but the throne of God, the Lamb. This is verse 3. Verse 4, they shall see his face. His name shall be in their foreheads. There'll be no need of night, no candle. The sun, the Lord gives them light. They shall reign forever. The picture that you have here, when it talks about the 12 fruit and the 12 months and them coming to worship, is that during that quote-unquote creation that there are times, I don't know how he's going to do time, but he actually mentions months there. There are times where we will gather up for what you and I might call worship. And then we go out and we enjoy the creative order that he's given for us. Now, I don't know exactly what that means, but I'm into it. I really am. I mean, that sound, I mean, can you imagine? You know, we sing the song Amazing Grace when we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun. We've no less days to sing God's praise than when we just begun. I would dare say, now this is just me speaking, that if we gave you 10,000 years as we know them, you could not completely, fully explore even planet Earth. And look at how large the creative order is. How much would be, could be, is out there, etc. So again, I don't know exactly. I do know there will be times of worship per Revelation 22. I do know there's a creative order which God always intends for inhabitation and to enjoy. However, I would almost positively guarantee you do not have to worry about wearing a tunic and playing a harp. I can almost guarantee that. That is a fabrication of the movies and nothing to do with scripture. And can I just be honest with you? For some people, that would be hell. Thanks for being a part of today's Daily Question. Now, we answer a question each and every day. Please feel free to submit a new question at AskJeff.net. We may not have gotten to yours today, but we eventually will. Continue to be a part of this. Subscribe so you don't miss out on a question every day.